My friends talk to her, as I'm talking right now, many questions are running in my mind, and some of them I cannot answer them at this time, because I don't have a clue. I'm still shocked what happened the day before yesterday. You know, football is my game, and I always love and support Chelsea Football Club at heart. I guess you remember when I was 22 or 3 the day, I saw 5 goals from my father's trousers, which he had thrown in my inner washing basket, and we used that money to buy tickets for 2. For this movie called Yellow Card, which was a soccer game movie. I only remember Woodsyard was among its characters. So you see, no matter what time that you buy, Taka's opportunity is to take from yellow to sky blue by Batu. Winning is my everyday goal. I know you still remember when I was in grade 7 at the inter-house athletics competition, when I tripped Nache, that tall guy being the name, at the inequality challenge. And he fell down, and I was disqualified from that race. Since my childhood, I never liked to see someone winning before me. But yesterday, I just chose Prince Head for second place. So I bet. It went this way. Yesterday, early in the morning, my dad gave me $100 to pay for my school fees in full for this term. It was the same day that my team, Chelsea, played against Paris Saint Germain, PSG. I was attracted by the odds and the money which was placed in favor of Chelsea if we were to win the match that night. I then decided to bet the other players, which was a supplementary to my school fees. If Chelsea won, I was supposed to get $740 in return. I had a win in my mind to bet because for the past 10 years, we were doing attention. PSG had never won against Chelsea. And I wanted the sports news saying Zlatan Ibrahimovic, PSG, with his striker yet and injury, so I thought Chelsea was going to win the match. I liked my mother that day in the evening around 8 p.m. that I was going for a discussion and to tell what she said. She did not ask me too many questions since I did not pass quite well in lower sixth, third term, and I was now in my last year in high school. So seriously, is what she likes to see. I carried small books in my satchel and I went to watch the soccer match. The match started so around 9 p.m. and Chelsea players were so energetic as well. On the other side, PSG was using the 5-3-2 formation. It was not playing football, but rather defending. It used the base formation or the defensive formation tactic. Our first goal from Chelsea was scored by William, a right wing player assisted by Hazard. When I saw a score in my eyes, I put myself together. Buying a necklace for my girlfriend from a jewelry shop at Joanna City cost $240. In the end, it was $110. The jewelry box was a surprise to my girlfriend, Angeline. Since I didn't give you anything on Valentine's Day, but just a phone call because I had traveled with my family to the burial of my late grandfather, Maxwell Akata. We finished the first half, the score rate 1-0. The second half was a bit tough because PSG was now attacking as well as defending. PSG scored its first goal from Cavani. I was a bit shocked but also losing no hope. At the same time, our left winger Hazard was tripped in the penalty area by PSG defender David Glen, and we were given a penalty. But unfortunately, the penalty was given to Azabuelter, and failed to score the penalty because he had a torn muscle, and he made a cover back. I was shocked to Tapiwa, and I was a bit nervous because time was ticking. It was around 78 minutes in the game. In the 85 minutes of the game, I was so angry, and I couldn't stand still. Started looking around the room. Chelsea was under pressure in Hazard, and Diego Costa had an injury. PSG was given a free kick, and without wasting time, they made two passes towards the 18th area, and Cavani made a tactical 360 degrees turn against our best defender and he tripped himself up while our goalkeeper practiced tried to dive in to catch the ball, but it was already in the net. I had a fever the whole day, the whole body, and shivering followed. Sweat started running through my body. I felt a stomach ache, and I couldn't sit down on the chairs. And I wasn't concentrating on the football, but rather had a vision of my father beating me up. I knew my father very well when it comes to his fever. He used to beat up my older brother with brooms and electric wires. I could not believe that the man had gone for good. My mind was full of sorrow. I went back home with tears on my cheeks and I had a headache. Many questions started running through my mind, thinking of the money. The $100 which I was given was the last money in my mother's handbag. On my way home, I tried to go back home, but my father, when he saw me, started chasing me and I rushed down the streets. He failed to catch me. I was in fear and I decided to stay in the streets because my father was angry and someone had seen me in the soccer shop betting the $100 money. So he had gossiped. I decided to sleep in the bar near Mapova shopping center. The night wasn't that good. It was around 10 p.m. and I was very hungry. I decided to buy ground nuts, which were sold outside the bar. The weather was so cold, and in my life, I never slept outdoors. So it wasn't a good experience. I slept for about 5 hours and I woke up. I couldn't sleep simply because of the noise and music. I wasn't happy anymore. Two other boys started fighting a prostitute inside the bar. Nobody even tried to stop them. These boys kicked and slapped this lady. I was so scared and bitter, and I felt as if they were beating my own sister. That's what gave me the courage to go to these boys and stop them from the bad things that they were doing. I tried to speak to them, but they wouldn't listen. One of them saw me trying to stop the other from beating up this prostitute, and he went in front of me. He slapped me and kicked me in the stomach. I fell down and he started beating me up together with that prostitute. Realizing that these two men were stronger than me, and I was tired. And because of that, I got up and rushed out of the bar. I waited outside and I stayed under a mango tree. And because of that, I slept under the tree until morning. Until finally, I decided to go back home and apologize to my parents for the worst thing that I had ever done to them. I was shocked my mother was so happy together with my dad and my sister, forgetting that I had disobeyed them.
So much so that we can see you. That is Bruce that wrote that story. Next up, we're going to have Carmoni reading Arnold's story.
I'll read the story written by Arnold. She's dark in complexion, long hair, pink lips, thin waist, white lips. Let her know. And always in long dresses, always smiling. She is a God-fearing person. That's the girl I love. I first saw her at the shops, we looked at Anna and we smiled at her, but she didn't come. This happened for several days, and I started calling for this girl, but it didn't happen that quickly and how I feel about her. She's so beautiful that I never thought she would fall for me or tolerate me, and to tell her about love. I was scared to tell her or even to talk to her until one day I decided to greet her and she responded nicely with a welcoming smile. I asked her name and she told me, likewise, I told her again. We exchanged more numbers. That's the day we became friends. The most amazing thing is that we have the same taste for music, movies, except sports. She is into baseball and I'm into basketball, handball, and volleyball. Soccer and tennis, but not that much. I invited her to a place to watch one of my high school games. And then she invited me to a place for a movie, a comedy, a wedding place. I stared at her and she asked me what was that all about. And that's the day I proposed to her. This time I was scared of ruining our friendship. She simply told me that we were friends and do better than me. But I kept on insisting for our state. She told me she felt the same way for me. And if we fall in love, we start to fight and lose each other. We started dating and things were perfect. We had fun, no fights, but fun always. We spent some quality time together, went shopping, sometimes we played my chain or hers. One day we went shopping and we got all the things we needed. At the till, she asked me if I love her. I didn't get why she asked me that question. I told her I love her so much, and she said I should go get her some pets. To be honest, I didn't know where to start from. I went to the shelf where the pets were. There, a certain man and girl were there, and I was shy to pick one. So I passed the shelf like I'm looking for something. But because I love my girlfriend, I was supposed to do it. I just grabbed myself to get two packets of pets. At the till, she screamed, "Wow, these are my favorite. How did you know?" you're my boyfriend. People at the till started laughing. And a certain old lady came up front and said, "Banana, kurani, magana." Who's like, "Hey, it's about children." And I told them, "We'll invite you now." Things were perfect during our 6 months of dating until one day, her mom found out about us. At first, she was told by a church member, and then she started investigating until she found our WhatsApp chat. And she simply told her daughter to stop seeing me and to have nothing to do with me. She told her I was a bad girl and I would distract her from the studies. But that was not true because I was a motivation. Because of her mom, she was scared to continue dating me since we have no option but to do as her mom says, went separate ways. We just stopped helping each other. We went for 2 months without seeing or talking to each other. But I don't want to lie to you. I was thinking of her every day and the good time to spend with her. And the plans we had for each other. Until one night, I decided to call her. I told her we need to talk in person. So we decided to meet the following day. She came in my face and I told her how much I miss her and how much I love her. She told me she loves me too, but the biggest challenge was her mom. She told me she was going to talk to her mom, but I didn't know how. She went home and told her mom that I was a bad guy and I was the reason why she was 13.8 of me because I was the one who thinking most of the time together. The mom was happy to hear this and she told her if she really wants me and if her heart is telling me that I'm the one, we should continue dating. One day, they invited me over for dinner at her place and her mom was there. She apologized for judging me and told me it was fine because she was trying to protect her daughter and because she wanted the best for her daughter. She has the right to do so. As for me and her girlfriend, things were perfect once again and her mom blessed our relationship. And at that time, we would go to church together with her mom. We were having fun as a family. That's the end.
The man with the beautiful girl. We're going to have a final interview story next. Oh, and she's also going to retell the story too.
I'm going to tell you a lot of the story. Family, love, sacrifice. We were lucky to know the importance of life and the responsibility of it. Even though I was popular, as I usually think in the childhood, things were about to turn to a new age. I got my body who was in the UK, but not for other home ones like me, it was a life of poverty. Bullies were there, there was terror. The first time of them, they would come and push the home ones around to take home from them. Reported to the master of authority. As for me during this time of terror, I would make my brother alone. If there is a man, no one would touch me. He was huge and never made his mind. No one dared to look at him when he was angry. He would clap him and knock you out for at least 10 minutes. Unfortunately, one day he got sick and was sent home. Sawanda, one of the most faithful, he decided to take the opportunity to make my life a little better. He tormented me for 2 days while my brother was around. When he got back, I told him what I did. Then later, at the window, Tawanda was put to the room. He pushed him against the wall. It was very angry. He told him never to see him again. As he let him fall to the ground, he got up by the middle of the room. Tawanda took the opportunity to reported my brother's situation. The brother that was his voice has been in the but from that day on, no one thinks that.
And then we'll have Tawanda's story.
I am a prophet and slave to the life that I'm living. I'm not living the way I like, but I'm living the life that no one never ever admired or dreamed it. When I grew up to know that I was living under poverty, I have a tremendous and intelligent way. Decided to self and self comprehend to get a better living. Where I was born, where I was self marked. In many moments of our living in 2021, which led me to nothing but trouble, me in the police captain to receive the stories of the people that I love. The thing that I am more obsessed with is to make my mother proud. My mother always wanted to be a business woman, though she runs a small business. My mission is to financially and make her get her own big boutique shop in the castle because she is a good dealer and a good woman and buy her. Dream of having a big mansion in the suburbs. I grew up in a family of Christianity and used to go to church regularly, and so I decided to stop going to church because I had to look for money for school. I did all that because I felt like God was knowing what I wanted to do with the man, well, much more with the man. I want to try to make it like a faith of the same thing for a long time, and nothing changed. And because of that, I thought God was not. Was no use. Until one day I had a pastor on the wire preaching and saying that all our prayers are being met and he wants us to see if we are patient enough and become that they set expectation. Now I'm praying to God so that he can show me where my problems is and lead me in the right path. Things seem to be getting better this way. And I met a beautiful lady in my neighborhood who introduced me to art and I made and I ever seen. And ever since I got here, I've made a lot of friends. I'm now amazed by acting and writing plays to the extent that I even write about things that I have been in my community and even copyright characteristics of different people and human acting. Writing stories and acting have brought happiness in my life now, and I'm really enjoying it. And every time I think of being in the region, I begin to
the next story that we're going to have was written by Tatenda and it's going to be read by Liberty.
Hi guys. Hi. I'm going to read a story by Tatenda and it's being one. Ever since I started going for health checkup, my doctor encouraged me to exercise and not to take fat foods. So every morning I exercised to keep my body fit. One day I was sprinting in the park near the shopping center. I heard a woman's voice behind my back shouting my name. Then suddenly I stopped and turned in to see who it was. My eyes could not believe. It was her, Jasmine. My brain went cooling. We last saw each other in 2001 when I was 35, and now we meet after 12 years. After 12 whole years. With joy, she jumped and hugged me at the same time as if I had helped. Just come to a coma. There was nothing to do, so I just had to dance according to the situation. I could hear her heart pounding inside me. With a smile, she looked into my eyes and said, "All these years we haven't changed, Tatenda." I replied, "Yeah." You look gorgeous, girl. I wonder what you're eating all this year. We both looked at each other and then we walked along the path. We walked along the path. She said to me in the park, she asked, what are you doing for a living? I just looked at her with a smile on my face and I replied, nothing. She said, come on, don't be shy. Then I'm working on a project based on a hybrid car. Wow, this must be a big project. What is it all about and where did you learn all of that? A few years ago, after completing my high school education, then I enrolled in automotive engineering as a mechanic at St. Peter's Batana Technical College. I got more interested in mechanics. I started my own research about the machines that produce the turning force without using fuel injected engines. My aim was to reduce carbon gases emitted by vehicles, which endanger the environment. The invention had less maintenance costs and it was efficient. The lab of these machines grew much bigger and it kept me from writing my trade test exam because I used the exam fees to fund the project. My mother got angry and she took everything. So what did you do? She asked. I borrowed a couple of dollars and I started again my research. My brother told me that my idea was already invented. I was wasting time. In that moment, I felt very weak. Then my legs could be up my upper body. So I managed to support myself on the feet. The vision I had of making millions of dollars a month and being popular, I could not watch my dreams flash away like that. So I continued to research on the hybrid weaknesses, and my task was to make them strong. Many months of research passed, and I managed to change quite a number of weaknesses. I applied for a patent of my invention, and I was approved to be able to produce more cars. That's my story. So here I am. We spent just a few hours as we enjoy each other's company.
Thank you guys for listening. I appreciate that. So this was basically, like I said in the beginning, that we focused on creative writing, and also at the same time we focused on playwriting. So this was the story writing part where I realized that, okay, fine, the last time most of these guys wrote a piece of work, it was probably in high school when they were writing, it was a composition, all those guys with essays, and I just thought, I think it would be fun to have this guy also explore. And as you can tell, some of the stories are very futuristic, and this is some of the things that has not even happened in their lives. But I constantly just try to push them, say, okay, fine, what do you dream about? You know, what kind of a person would you like to be in the future? So write about that. Tatita wrote about being a mechanic and an engineer. And Taliwa wrote about being bullied in school and having the big brother protect them. So you find out this was so many different stories. And these are not the only stories that they wrote. They wrote so many stories that at the end of the day, at the end of the 5 days, the last day, we just said, okay, fine. Because of the sake of the presentation, we're going to pick one. So the process was largely based on just pushing them to write as much as possible. And I think they can attest to the fact that they wrote a lot. Right? And they still have lots and lots of work that they could present if we had more and more time. Okay, so we're going to move to the dialogue session. So what I like to put on to the dialogue is that I was also looking for a different way to approach playwriting, and I say to them, okay guys, right, I'm not going to make your lives very difficult. I just want you to go and eavesdrop. No matter how to wrote out again, I won't be overset. Because what I was when you were right, your conversation. And after you write that conversation, I want you to imagine and expand on that conversation. So what you're going to hear next is actually a product. So you find out maybe possibly the first 5 to 8 lines are the actual lines of the conversation that they eavesdropped on. And then the rest of the conversation they made up on their own. You find out some of the conversations went really, really wild. When some of them had car chases and so forth and so on. And I constantly just encourage them, say, you know what? The world is big. So do, I mean, just ride as big as you want, go as wild as you can. So that's what you're going to hear next. So the first story that we're going to hear was written by Tatenda, and it's going to be read by Molly, Liberty, and Patience. So we have a child in the house.
How may I help?
I'm Detective Stewart, and this is Detective Johnson. Do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
No, I don't mind. Come inside, take this.
Thank you. How long have you known Richard Terera?
Since secondary school, from there we became close friends.
When was the last time you saw
him? I saw him about a year.
Did Richard ever mention about what he does with him?
He said he was a project manager for a certain company which he never mentioned.
Do you know where you might find him?
He has no fixed address, I don't know where he might be found.
Thank you for cooperating with me.
You're welcome.
Sir, I almost forgot. Do you mind if I see your ID?
Yes.
Thank you once again, sir. Have a good day. Door closes. They walk towards the account. This guy is hiding something. I can smell it. Let's monitor his movements. I saw a bunch of receipts on his display, so I managed to pull this one out without being seen. He deposited $4,500. Where did he get that kind of money?
Something smells fishy about this guy. Let's head back to the office.
David deposited $4,500 into Richard's account last Tuesday. Here is the duplicate of the transaction.
Ronnie, look into this guy's records. I want all these bank transactions.
Give me 15 minutes.
I give you 5 minutes.
You are the boss.
I want to know what they are up to.
Bingo, here is our guy. David Musa, born in Nashville on the day of November 1980. He grew up in Harare. At the age of 17, he was arrested for stealing money from his neighbor. At 30, he was involved in unsolved cases and dealing drugs. Richard also transferred $4,800 into the factory account and they withdraw $7,500.
That's our guy. I want you to monitor his calls, every move he makes, and I want them both in my company by the end of the week.
So, Stuart, your wife was here a few minutes ago. She left a note on your desk.
Okay, what did she say?
Nothing. It seemed if she was in the house.
Come on, Cherry, pick up.
Say, there's a call on David's cell phone.
Meet me and join us at the second floor. There's a van next to Chicken's Life. Make sure I don't get bored.
I have the location of the caller. He's on the second floor, 30 degrees inside of the trailer's kitchen.
Alright, guys, pay attention to this one. I want them both alive.
So like I say that some of the stories get very fascinating. And that is to tell the piece that we're making you kind of for that. So there's more and more to the story. Some of the stories I personally had to cut them short. Like for example, a couple of scenes that I also had to cut out from the story just for the sake of time. That was the tender. The next story that we're going to have was written by Lazarus, and it's going to be read by Molly, Patience, and Liberty. Let's clap hands for them, is it?
Otu akamira pagate pana kaida achimudaidza kuti vaende kuchechi kwayo. Kaida, kaida, tanuno vaende kuchechi. Ndakuuya waiti only for about a second, stand up around.
Nasi kumapita vachataura kuti tiedzeti muka kuberi kwayo.
Hatisati tarona kuti tine 10 minutes kuti 6 o'clock achaya.
Tichazofamba.
Kaida akataka mugodzi, ofambidzana naotu achienda kuchechi kwayo.
You know my dreams, my dream. I want to be a gospel singer. The second thing they require.
But we're not going to tell
this one. And deployment thing is not only one.
Yeah, I'm telling you this because all the world is here. So,
tap the sheet and yet you may say.
What's that for time? After church, why are you talking about church?
Oh, did I say it is?
Bantu
kumanya. Tino
kumanya
teso. So, I think dine something to put out.
So, also, actually, dine vini to put out because you want to be a gospel singer.
I know that. Wakandu mkutu.
I thought you understand.
Yeah, I really understand, but if you love me, that does not mean you should not focus on your dreams.
Yeah, I know. But Negeshawa, I'm sorry, it would be nice if we become friends.
Okay. So what can I do to help you to achieve your dreams?
For being my friend.
Maybe you can come to my house and talk about Pilates.
That would be a good idea. Because we may still be good at my male voice. Maybe you can sing that part.
Okay, I'll be happy to help you.
So I'll see you tomorrow. Thank you for understanding.
You're welcome. See you tomorrow.
After church, I have to come up with them. When I ask her, I'm not
ah, sorry, I think that's in the message. I'm not going to ask. It's not what you think. Do you remember that song in the name of this?
Yeah.
Do you understand that in the comments? It's also a good one.
Okay, but they want to move. Nothing that's open.
So,
this is not what I'm going to send that night.
Great. You send it a night after 4 days. It needs time to get to the back.
So, I'm the child of Sotora Mamba.
Bye. Oh, do we need to go to the next test? But why? Why? What gives me another chance that I can make the mistake?
I don't know
how to do that. Wait a second. Come in.
Cheers, son. Must say, I'm not
going to go. I'm not going to go. No more special collaboration as well.
Get it on. Hi.
Well,
that's how I'm not going to change. That's right, come change. But the ex boyfriend, I'm going to go and get it on. I've got a quad.
Kuno kiwa mshongo wa kisa nisi.
Thank you, Paika. Nangani chikwata kumuni za mungu wani, doa utakute chini.
Unonya ya kwata ochi.
Shana, mungu wati sasibarangiri.
Ushani sasa jatawa wanangu ya nti, antitika.
Okay, don't worry.
Okay, but antimu mnyaya.
I know that.
Mangwana ndine test, so I need to read. So nukwana mangwana kutu. Chokwamba zi.
Okay, me too. I need to read because to kutanga kumiru nitu. God, please, the screen is going to kill me.
She.
Mungu what?
Fonia kwenye. Tifoni yawa, nekuma kwenye.
No, please, it's a phone.
Tinokubadzira sei unosvika pakufa.
Zvinani.
Haungafire muto iviti.
So fonerei namba dzakanyora kudzipaira.
Hello, ndipaira here. Shamwari yako iri kurwara nemunhu zviri serious. Taakutomuendesa kuhospital kwarinyatwa. Bye.
I wish I could die, Shamwari. Oh God, just kill me.
Azidana, come on.
You know what? You never see it.
It was at the hospital.
What? What was that?
Mshongo and the cash is a movie. Who could be what?
What that is that what I want?
Yeah.
Sure, I know
what. I'm sorry, but I have bad news.
Oh God, why?
Mshungo waka piu. Owe ni lani mbili. Rosa kwa wako wati wani.
I blame you, Paika. Kwa
hini
laika
say,
I'm
just naka kwa mshungo.
Girls, stop that. I sing kwa hiko choro kukadari.
Okay, fine.
You're going to have skin flash for about 15 years.
I'm sure. You should not say that. Thank God for helping you. It's not the end of the world.
But why me?
Don't worry. It will be okay. God will help you.
Yeah, God will help you, my friend.
Take care of yourself, but don't stress yourself.
Thank you, doctor, for helping my friend.
I did not know what to do, my friend.
It will be okay. I will try to turn up in the
so I will.
Okay, so I'll take a save at the
I will find you.
Okay, but then I'll see you soon.
I will try to comply later.
See you tomorrow.
Goodbye. I'll see you tomorrow.
After 5 minutes, Kaida and Luna.
I'm done with this night.
Then Otto jumps from the 16th floor to the ground and dies at the end.
I find it fascinating that story of Daniel and Nkoman. And the next story that we are going to hear was written by Patricia. And one thing that I'll say about Patricia is she was the only girl in the group. We had another girl initially in the group, but just came in for a day, and the next day she just disappeared. But thank you so much, Patricia, for sticking it through. Usually it's very, very difficult for one person. But Patricia stayed throughout the whole workshop. So thank you so much. So the story is going to be read by Faro and Patience.
I don't know what to do.
Take on other women. I thought that was interesting. Right, next we're going to have Arnold's story, which is going to be read by Melody, Privilege, and Mufara.
Yes, that's what I want to do. I'm going to go to the house. 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 I'm going to go
Okay, can I go by 30 minutes?
Kondanza kutotelwa baby, ito kadiri.
Yes, ma wani.
Saka ndoshi kukurotejo, kuta stress, ni muna kutika sika mba kwa mela, ina ndi, na ndi stress kusika mba.
Ana deep drink na kutetele, na ntukulita, aya kinye mfeli. Niko chino kune wana wakati wakati wakati
wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati wakati
Shama,
then I feel like a stand. You put out a
lot
of food, and then you have to go home and you have to go home. Because I'm going to have to go home. I don't know how to go home. I don't know how to go home. I don't
know how to go home. I don't know how
Muchi, spending. Bapana, kama wenda kuko tele mtu kwenye kumani wa mbeni wa kachata ya.
Mwani ni wachita sayi? Mwani wachita wati?
Okay, ina ni mtawari ya kini mpana wako. Kusitu. Right. Kuko na zenya ya kwa ii chawala. Mkanzi wa kisha rabisha kata ii. Woda kumura. Hehe. Kuchiro unochi wana kutuwa. Kwa kushia kwa pati. Chunozi mkanzi 85%, murume 50%.
Diva, ma kunye kwa food, that's not fair. Tufanu, nana kita 50-50.
Haa, iyo, 50-50 no peke, ewe. Tanyamunu, wewe kuno kumara ina kanzu wala, mtiri kwa shaa. Aka njengeza imba, muna nziyaka kuwa 85%. Ichika jino chakadara, shaa.
Tawana, wakutu kwa tawa wadareka kukai, sa nchina rani. Kukai, kukai,
So, one of the things that I can tell you to tell when you have the sessions is that I was not restrictive in terms of the language that you could use. Tinyora in the language that you are most comfortable with. And some of them did write in English, some of them wrote in Shona. And I said everything was fine. Nyango kadagu nyora Shonglish on English. And you were nyora on Nigerian cheetah. So that was one of them. I thought that was very, very funny. Even when I read it at home, I was second one. Right, now the next story that we're going to here was written by Tadiwa, and it's going to be read by Privilege, Patience, and Liberty.
Tadiwa entertained a meet one afternoon in one of their usual disputes. Tatenda then realizes that Lizzie's views about him deciding to finish his A levels in Spaces College.
For Spaces in the house.
So, Chi, let us say, because of what I do.
Man, just that one is in your bachelor.
Media.
When I am planning a good quorum for all the world reasons, apart from the situation, my name was better show to my guide now.
A woman and men meet outside their workplace and begin talking about related problems during their lunch hour.
As far as I can tell, I'm not sure if you are a person who is a
person. I'm not sure if you are a person. But I'm not sure if you are a person.
So one from Spaces, and the other one that you had, those were two conversations. The next, and the next one that we're going to hear is from Bruce. It's going to be read by Melody and Mufara.
Yeah, I'm going to be my size of
David Amphibian, and then people have an appetite to take up the Zimbabwe. And then enters the Zimbabwe and they started talking.
Yeah, that's not much.
So, the rest, all the work that has been read was created by this guy. And these are the stars that you saw, the everything that you saw, they were just merely there for everything purposes. But these are the stars, and thank you for taking your time to just listen to them. So I'm going to give each and every one of them just 10 seconds to say something about their experience or anything that they want to say to you guys. 30 seconds, 30 seconds, 30 seconds. Okay.
My name is Patricia Chukwila. Takatanga,
Sometimes you know what it is, but it's not like you know. Singing for myself, I'm not going to teach. even an asta kutanga kuti zvichadzidza zvakubatsira tichinda kuma kidzi wetu chine chavo changa chichikunzi zvoitwa kozi munari munhu kwanisa kutaura even kana une maproblems kana munhari free wekuti unofila comfortable wekuti zvine anoisa anoti uve shamwari neshamwari zvokuti iwe unova free kuti zvine even kana uchidzidza unonyatsotyisisa kana kuti unonyatsobudisa zvamuri chaio tinda kuti thank you.
At first, I was just completely so I don't shoot you with them. Because, like I said, I'm just saying, I don't get up at next. Where we are going, but what do you think? You can grow and have any more, even if it's not play, I'm so. So I knew that you are. Just like when I was a commander, I'm not going to have any play or play, since you still have to beat a Bible. So I don't think I want to get to it. Mama days in days away. Pambali no musu kunda kana nduka chiku kila time chiku lenga lenga kuti vangondo vana nengo yo kumakisa register. So takaso uya shukuri kuti parwe ana kiti. So this is our true. Bikati vatanga kuti matira wae. Chari kuti kuti shandisa. Ndiri mwe mukyo first day. So ndakatanga kuti exercise ndakatanga kuti aya ina kiti. Kuti next day ratidata kusvika panapa ikatogadzira tuma benches kuti ndanda kiza ndatitaka kuti school how to write so tikana ndazvo iye this match bab okay
ya ini ndi kuti tadiwa ali esto kuonda kutenda mese mawa na zvatatishita basi last week, no motivator for now to be such support from the community. Because ever since when I go here, I go here to go to the smoke, and I move on from the TCT government, everyone has the interest in the community, the theater, but I do not want to get an honor, and I don't want to get an interest in the theater, so I don't want to get an honor. And I go to the theater, and I go to the Almasi team. My child and move mountains and us, but I'm not the same guy I was 2 weeks ago. And it is, but was my mind. Hopefully, the child will be put up to time and say, you know.
Why don't you need to reach each other cheap and need to have a single goal? And I'm very negative and active, but when I was the only aunt, I'm talking about it, but I don't know what to do with the to what I can just work is to play, to promise now, to promise now, to promise now, to promise now, to share the seal, but to train that is to play, but I end up saying I'm but now from the arch, some bogus areas and you can wait down. That was in your way. Talk this only order, I lose my host to your hands. I can have Jesus critical for my host to your order. Still, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it.
My name is Tatanda Jilwewa, and I'm a photographer in the team as well for my attention. Not to have a bit of a back on the way to one of our team is in Baba. To know what was flown in us, and look to what I did this was what's going on. Sometimes they go to the team and say, it's a way. It's a way. It's a way. It's a way. Why? Because that's not the first one. Not to be famous about Master, but my zero right. But we are still learners. I admit that. Right. So, after that, so Fabira made the workshop. Zagata was a big up. Some of us that have a high school at the time. So, Zagata was a pick up from Chaka graduate from Chino Lena to?
First day.
Yeah. So, chaka experience at the moment. Now, I think Mandi, you need to learn my skills at the moment. And also, I did also do a lot of my plays without my hassles or any problems. Right? Then, the other thing which I now notice about the I have to take another move. I could see my mistakes and why? Because that was the time to move, you know, you were saying. I could see what happens in the objective, any obstacle, any tactic. But some of my move are not true now. And my objectives are regarding. And in a game move, you know, you go without energy. And but they help you to go now, move on the team. The team will be all massive. I got to Basila, to Tiri, to Equip in mind. This is what you could do, and as to know what to do.
So, the last thing I want to say is first day, I think I'm going to talk to the tower. The Pandavati went to the island of Pera. And that is how I can waste them out to when they could see one night if drop in a conversation. I'm going to talk to you about it. So why I'm saying this is my passion. As Munagaku Rogu Ghetto is that Chinipanaka perception that Tinako could not know Chinese that no one saw get a chit up about food and get a phone for the Gafuera, can get a phone for the Gafuera, she was a Fira Papo, if I go to A level and I feel it's not Kumira Papo. So my passion is just to make sure that Isus Wagaku Ram Ghetto and Macho Ghetto, we can be able to do it as much as anybody else. We have the talent, we have the skill. And I think it's very, very important. We can do it. Because over the course of just 5 days, and these guys were able to create work that surprised even themselves. Right. So I feel that thank you so much, Auntie, for providing such a platform. And thank you, Almasi, for providing such a platform. And be able to share some of the skills that I learned. And thank you so much to this. These guys are University of Zimbabwe students. They're studying theater. I was also a student at the University of Zimbabwe about 2 years ago, studying theater as well. So usually my grammar is not in the room because once I don't get a children in the town, those are the town. So I urge you guys to just keep supporting these guys. Based upon anytime they do an activity, I know they're going to miss the play soon. Please. So just support them. Thank you so much. And to all the parents and the friends and the relatives, boss or owner, just keep supporting them. Thank you so much. Auntie, there are certificates that are going to be presented to the guys for being part of the workshop. I'm going to ask the Associate Artistic Director of Almasi Collaborative Arts to come to the front and then just present the certificates to them, and Auntie too, to just come to and present the certificates.
Thank you.
So when you come through, guys, you just hand you a certificate so that these guys can also get photos with you, Auntie, and Elizabeth Mchema. So the first one is Tadiwa Ali. Then we have Munashe Cherela. Munashe is not around. Patricia Chibida. Tawanda Chimbade. Thank you.